Hello and welcome to this Instant Terra tutorial. In this video, we will create a simple terrain and look at all the basic nodes. Let's start by adding a Perlin noise node. Modify the terrain by tweaking the scale and height in the properties panel. Our goal is to create a mountain landform that we will be able to reuse easily. We only want to keep the rough shape, so we reduce the number of detail levels. Most generator nodes have a randomized seed. Changing it produces a different yet similar result. We set the elevation range using a minimum and maximum node. I want this shape to be roughly 300 meters high. As our mountain should blend with the terrain's border, we create a smooth hemispheric terrain. Don't forget you can lock the 3D viewport on a node by pressing the space key. This allows you to modify any of its inputs and still see the result. We multiply our landscape using this bell shape. The general structure is good, we can now focus on adding details. We sum a ridged noise node with an apply curve node to get sharp features. The apply curve node is used to transform the terrain's elevations. What is really powerful is that you can paint the curve in real time. Let's tweak the tiling and the height again. Now it's beginning to take shape. We're going to reuse an apply curve node, but this time using curve point editing. In this mode, it's easier to reshape your terrain without adding any more detail. Now add a mountain erosion node to give us sharp crests. This node simulates the effect of fluvial carving over a wide time span. The four parameters change the way the terrain ages. Add another layer of noise to get a bit more variation. And don't forget, if you're not satisfied with your result, you can always lock the last node and tweak any of the graph's parameters. By blending the terrain before and after transformation, you can control the influence of an effect. Now we link a hydraulic erosion node to add the final details. This node creates realistic erosion effects by simulating rainfall and river carving. When the simulation runs, you can observe the water layer as well as the sediments created by the erosion. Again, set the elevation range with a minimum and maximum node. Lastly, we will make the terrain blend with the borders. As before, multiply a terrain by a bell shape to get a smooth transition. we've completed our first terrain. Thank you for watching this video. See you soon for more Instant Terra tutorials.